getting booked for a couple shows, you know. Got booked for a little Pusha T, little shit, Big Thirdly, Seeing Mulatto, ODPs. I getting booked for a little bit of show, man. I ain't gonna lie, my 2020 has started out good, bro. My first album name wasn't even like that, you feel me? Yeah. I started getting booked for a lot of shows. I'm like, nah, damn, probably about to take off.
What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Leek and I'm back with another video, man. And by the title, y'all already know what kind of video it is, so I ain't gotta get into depth with what this video is, cause by the title y'all know it's an interview. It's an interview with my boy B4L, Sosa Baby. And he been dropping a whole lot lately. And he got a mixtape that about come out, but I'm gonna stop all the talking. We're just gonna get straight into the interview. Go ahead and call him right now. And we're gonna, you know what I'm saying, get this interview started. Cause that's what we doing. Yes,
yo,
sir.
Yo. What's up, nigga?
What's going on with you, gang?
Ain't nothing chilling, man. Trying to get the money, man. You know, trying to make 2020 start all right. So what you, bro? How you
2020,
been?
You mean 2021, bro?
2021, man.
I'm already knowing, bro.
Hey,
you
think we can start that video back up?
Nah, hey, we gonna get that in there. They gotta see that, man.
You got me.
But
yeah, man. Trying to start it all right, man. For real, bro. No, a lot of hell shit going on right now, bro.
I'm already knowing, bro.
Man, trying to focus on my music and everything, bro.
So, shoot, since you speaking of music, bro, go ahead and, you know what I'm saying, let's get straight into it. Like, how the music going for you anyway?
Shit, the music going good. I ain't gonna care if I got my album about to drop on January 29th.
Yeah, I had seen it.
Yo, so y'all stay tuned on that. I ain't gonna lie, that shit got some heat on that shit. I ain't gonna lie, got a couple different artists on there.
If you don't mind me asking, how many tracks you got on there?
I ain't gonna lie, I got like 8. I probably need like 2 more though.
Two more?
Trying to make that kind of big. Yeah, trying to get like 10. Okay, yeah, trying to make them feel me on this one, you feel me?
Hell yeah.
This one they gotta take off.
Yeah, and I seen you been dropping visuals lately, man. A whole lot.
Yeah, dropping a couple videos. You know, I feel like I gotta drop a little bit more, you feel me?
Yeah,
feel me? I gotta drop a little more. Gotta get my views up though. I gotta try to get my views back up. Sure. You feel me?
Shit, when you think you dropping another music video?
You said when they think I dropping another one?
Yeah, like another music video.
Shit, I ain't gonna lie, I think about dropping one probably like in 2 weeks. I waiting on my nigga E. He trying to see what's up. Nah, he trying to go to No Shake and shit, trying to see what's up. Cause we got a hard ass song, I ain't gonna lie to you. So that shit about to be hard, yeah. So it probably like in 2 more weeks.
Alright.
Yeah, stay tuned on that.
Do you think you gonna drop like a single before you drop the tape, or you just gonna wait till you drop the tape and you just gonna push that?
I think I might just push that one because I ain't feel like I pushed my other one that much. So I think I should push this one a little bit more.
And I'm pretty sure you're gonna do visuals to some songs off that. How many tracks off the tape you gonna like make visuals for?
Let me see. I ain't really know. I probably make videos for like six of them songs, probably like six or five of them. I know I gotta get that album kind of jump, gotta get it better than the last, you feel me? I've been seeing you been doing shows lately, man, tell me about it.
Yeah,
you see that, man? I was getting booked for a couple shows, you know, got booked for Lil Pusha T, little shit, Big Thirdly, Seeing Mulatto, ODPs. I getting booked for a little bit of show, man. I ain't gonna lie, my 2020 has started out good, bro. My first album name wasn't even like that, you feel me?
Yeah.
I started getting booked for a lot of shows. I'm like, nah, damn, probably about to take off. Trying to get booked for more.
Walk me through your first show. Like, what was your feeling? Like, what was going through your head when you did your first show?
You say who I want to hear when I get my first one?
No, I say like, walk me through your first show. Like, what was you hearing? Like, what was going through your mind when you did your first show?
Shit, Well, I ain't gonna lie to you, but I've been nervous, bro. When I got with Stevie, bro, on God, bro. You know, when I first got on that bitch, I said, damn, fuck. I had to try to get right on that bitch. I'm kind of nervous, but shit, I pushed through that shit. My niggas have pushed through that shit, bro.
Really?
Real. But I ain't gonna lie, that shit been lit, man. I ain't gonna lie. It been lit, bro. It been lit. I love that shit. I love that shit. I ain't gonna care.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. I just trying to wait. Oh.
As far as the music, man, like, who you working with in the city or in the state?
You said who I work with now, like some artists I work with?
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, I work on my man CW Pookie. I met my man Easy. I got a couple artists. I got my man EJ on that on the little track. I try to get a little big artists. I'm not trying to get like count up on that bit. You know, I got to pay that band though for it. You know, I might go ahead and do it, you feel me? Like, well, just go ahead and do that. That bitch out for that nigga, man, for real. I need him on that shit. But you know, I'm working with a couple artists.
Sure.
Yeah, just stay tuned. It's on unsigned artists, some niggas that people sleeping on.
Yeah.
You go take it off, man.
Like, as far as your producers and shit. And any specific ones you fucking with, really? Or you just fucking with whoever, you know what I'm saying, you can vibe with?
Yeah, I fucking with, I ain't gonna lie, I fucking with Marco, a lot. I'm fucking with June 2nd, you know, I fucking with both of them a lot. You know, they good.
Yeah.
I don't really know right now, I'm fucking with a lot of different people, you know. Yeah. But them two my main, you feel me? My main people, I really.
Sure. And see, you independent, right?
Yeah, independent, man. Independent. Got to do the shit independent.
Yeah,
yeah. I just can't wait till I sign something. I'm going to sign a deal soon. That when them niggas start hating, you feel me? That when they start hating. They already hating now, you feel me?
Yeah.
That when they really gonna start.
Shit, like, walk me through, like, you know what I'm saying, just your life and shit, like, you know what I'm saying, like, growing up, like, how it was for you and shit, like, you know?
Yeah, shit, growing up, it been tough, I ain't gonna lie to you. I can't pop a square. You know, I used to play sports, you know, football a lot. I mean, I've been good in football. You know, I've been on varsity since ninth grade, you know. I had people looking at me since my eighth grade year. Like, I've been kind of good at football, but I started getting in a lot of trouble and shit, you feel me? The streets just started, you know, the bullshit started happening. I started getting locked up, charged and dumb shit. I get kicked off my 12th grade year, I say, fuck it. Let me just see what's up with the rap shit, you feel me? My life been kind of tough, bro. I ain't gonna carry me a lot of tough, a lot of pain, bullshit, bro, for real. Like, but you know, we gonna keep pushing, man. Go keep pushing that shit, bro.
Yeah, and where you originally from?
I'm from Sumter, South Carolina, man. The Merc, 803, you know. You got that shit tatted on me. I'm like, you feel me?
Yeah.
That shit's on my neck. For real.
For sure, man.
Yeah, bro. On the same
going
up good.
So like, just, you know, just like, how long you been rapping? Cause you know, I see.
I ain't gonna lie to you. Like, I just started rapping. Like, I ain't gonna lie, in school, I used to been rapping a little bit, like fucking with it. I used to make songs out like an app on my phone and shit.
Yeah.
I used to fuck with it a little bit. You know, after that, people start telling me, say, Sosa, man, take that shit a little serious, man. I see football, you know, football ain't really going like how you want it to go. Try to take rap a little serious. Got now, I start going to the studio, you know, start posting my shit, and my shit start making a little buzz and shit, you feel me? I said, goddamn, people fuck with me. I said, goddamn, I start dropping a little bit more. Now I start getting booked for shows and shit. I said, goddamn, they know the music shit I'm fucking with. I'm like, shit, man.
For
real, man.
For sure, man. Shit, I see you been going, you know what I'm saying? Like, you been doing your thing lately, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? Your videos and shit, I'm still getting them plays, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody tuning in, man.
Yeah, they gotta do a little bit more, you feel me? I'm doing my little thing right now. I'm doing my thing. Start getting my little buzz up through the city, man. For real.
Yeah. For real. So, like, all your shows that you already had, they just been in South Carolina, or...
Yeah, I had some in South Carolina. I had one at the beach. You know, some of my shit been in the city, you know, around the city part. Yeah, I just went and really take off, and I, like, go to Georgia and shit, start going, like, big, you know, big city, you know, all that shit. You know, it go get there, though. You know, I'm just patient right now. But I doing a lot of local shows, you feel me? I ain't gonna lie. But the one that club drip at the beach, that shit been jumping. flippers in that bitch and all that, man. That bitch was jumping and count up in that bitch and what his name? Goddamn, who that nigga who made the song with him? I vibe, you know that shit. I vibe.
Yeah.
Mr. Cutter. I forgot that nigga said, PG Raw, PG Raw. Yeah.
Ah, man. That good though.
Oh yeah, man. I was saying they gotta keep pushing that shit, man. They're trying to get some more shows out of state.
Yeah, ain't shit wrong with that, man.
For real, they gotta keep running up that bag.
Hell yeah, shit. You got any like big artists that you damn might be working with in the near future? Or?
No, I fucking with a lot of these. I fucking with a lot of these big artists, but not really like that, you know. I mean, I keep trying to keep it a little independent for some of my niggas I fucking with now.
Yeah.
I got some hard niggas in my crew, I ain't gonna lie.
For sure.
Yeah, but in the future, I'ma fuck with a lot of big artists and all that, trying to get my buzz up better.
Yeah.
You know, like I said, I'm trying to get count up on my shit, so you know, I'ma see what's up with that. For sure.
For sure. And shit, and for like, you know what I'm saying, your fan base who don't got you on social media, like they only get fuck with you on like YouTube and shit, like, you know what I'm saying, like you wanna give them like your social media and shit so they can be in tune with you on the daily type shit?
Oh yeah, for sure. Like, y'all go add me on Instagram before social, baby. That way, you know, go run on my Instagram, bro. I be on Facebook a little bit, but not really. But y'all can go ahead and add me on social, baby, Root. You know? So y'all can go find me on YouTube before Sosa Baby and go ahead and run that shit up, bro. For real.
Hell yeah. Shit, man. Cause I seen when you first started, bro, cause you know we did some work, bro, and just looking back and looking at you now, bro, it's like, damn, my nigga, you know what I'm saying?
Man, my favorite video.
Yeah, my nigga coming a long way, bro.
Hey, you got me started, bro. You got me started. I'm like, and I appreciate that shit, bro. For real.
Man, you know it's all love, man.
This ain't much love, man. Much love. I'm gonna say, I gotta keep pushing this shit. You gotta keep pushing it.
Yeah. I really ain't want to go too in depth, cause I don't know what your situation is on the issue. But I seen you get locked up like a little while ago, man.
Hell yeah, little bullshit, little incident, little happy. You know, I innocent.
Yeah, for sure. We ain't gotta go too in depth. You know, I just had to, you know what I'm saying? I seen that shit. You know, like, man, I gotta ask bro about that, you know?
I didn't want to tell you my nigga slide for real, though. You know, my nigga slide. My nigga slide, man. Bullshit. But, yeah.
So, matter of fact, since you speaking on that, like, because I understand that's like a brotherhood type shit, right?
Yeah, a little brotherhood shit.
Man. So, like, like how that started up? Like, you know what I'm saying? The 4L, B4L.
Yeah, we been in my room, you know, back in Poplar Square, you know. It been me, my brother E, and my cousin Malik. We just playing the game and shit, smoking on the blunt and shit. And, you know, we just say, shit, we need a little gang and shit. Even though we got a lot of niggas who fuck with us, we need a little crew or some shit. So, first it started off at B3. Like, cause it was just three of us. Uh-huh. Shit, like, man, start shit B3, man. Fuck that. Then goddamn, my other cousin came in. He said, man, how y'all go do that, man? How y'all go ain't gonna put me in the game? Yeah, we said, man, fuck that. You gonna get in too, B4. Goddamn, he made that shit B4. Now, when those, a lot of niggas just start fucking with the vibe, you feel me? You know, we had a lot of niggas growing up with us, you know, coming up with us since Poplar Square, wanted to join the gang and shit, wanted to join the group, you know. You know, now we took that shit, tried to know push that shit a little bit, and that when niggas just start fucking with us, you know that. You know, I ain't really started, bro. People really think we like the gang and shit and all that shit, but we ain't no gang, no just brotherhood and shit.
Yeah, be for real, folks shit, no ho shit.
Go to party, no fuck.
Yeah, man.
For real. I'm saying. Saying
people,
man, I don't know my nigga out, man. I got that shit tatted on me, you feel me?
Yes, sir.
You feel me? Lost my nigga out there, you feel me? You know, he got shot in his head. Y'all know my nigga Ortega and shit. You know, I popped the square and, like, shit crazy.
Damn.
Yeah. See, I got that shit tatted on me, man. See, a lot of pain up in Poplar Square, bro. I ain't got a lot of shit going on.
You know? Yeah, I see. And I see, like, your music, bro, like,
I can, like, when you, you know what I'm saying, like, when you lay down on a track, bro, I can feel some of your pain, bro.
So, like, yeah, bro, I be talking that pain shit, because I live that shit.
Yeah.
I don't really try to talk about that shit. I don't really live, you feel me? That's where I get, though. You feel me?
Yeah.
I'm trying to talk shit, bro. Most of you niggas be capping in this shit, man. I don't be trying to do all that capping, bro. You gotta make the people feel, you feel me?
Hey, yeah, you'll be able to relate.
Yeah, they relate to you, feel me? When I say I got people fuck with me, and that's all I need. You feel me?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So shit, like, what really like just made you want to take rap serious though? Like, I know you say football ain't work out, but like, what pushed you to like be like, all right, fuck it, I'm gonna do this shit. I'm gonna just put everything I got in behind this motherfucker.
Shit, I ain't gonna lie, my brothers really pushed me. They pushed me the most, like, cause they see me, they see I got a bright future.
Yeah.
Like some days I feel like giving up on the rap shit for real. And I'm bored to keep pushing me. They say, man, so you can't just give up, bro. You got a big fan, but you got people counting on you, man, to keep pushing. You feel me? And, like, they're the reason why I'm really doing this shit here now, bro. You know, my cousin Kels, and that my dog right there, he the main one who pushed me every day, bro. Every day. Every day, you know, feel me? He be telling me, Sosa, man, just stay out in the mix, man. Keep your head up. You got to keep pushing on this shit, but you got people believing in you, man. So, you know, that my dog right there, and I, man. And much love for them, boy. So I said, we go blow
on them. And shit, how it feel, just to know that you got people in the city, people like not in the city, but just to know that it's people behind you because of your music.
Shit, it's love, bro. It's love, you feel me? It's love. And I appreciate them for doing that because they can help me take off, bro, you feel me? Because I know they know other people around the city, you know? Yeah. I love that shit, bro. Ain't no cap, bro.
Yeah, for sure, man. Shit. Any last words or any shout outs you want to goddamn give before we end the interview, man?
Shit, I want to say, man, shit, hey, big bullshit, man. Long live my nigga Hop, bro. Y'all boy, go follow me on Instagram, BPostSosa, man. And we about to take out 2021, nigga. On God, 2021 about to be the year, bro.
Yes, sir.
I say y'all stay tuned. The tape about to drop January 29th, The Escape. Y'all stay tuned, man. Y'all stay tuned, bro. For real, y'all stay tuned. You getting that bread up this year, bro. You getting that bread up this year.
Yeah, yeah. Got to, man.
Yeah, we got to.
Shit, well, keep doing your thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Stay positive out there, bro. Stay out of the way like your mans tell you, bro. And just keep going ahead with the music, bro. And you know when you drop the tape, you know I'm being tuned, for sure.
For sure, man. Stay tuned, man. I can't wait for you to get back here, man. This shit's a video with you, man.
Oh, man. You already know once I get back, we're going to go up.
Oh, yeah. You know that, man. For sure, man. Yes, sir.
Shit, all yeah, love, man.
My nigga, you know that, man.
You know I get out there quick. What they said, tell them get out my dick.